वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास 10 सब्जेक्ट साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 1 दैट इज केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस एंड दिस इज रिवीजन असाइनमेंट नंबर 2 सॉल्यूशन वीडियो. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट वी वर हैविंग दैट वाज आइडेंटिफाई द टाइप ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड वी वर गिवन 14 इक्वेशंस that we have to identify that which type of chemical reactions these are. Here in this assignment solution video, we'll only be doing the questions which seems to be a little tough or which needs a clarification from my side. Rest of the questions are easy and you can do them by yourself. So let us start discussing them. Here the first equation is calcium oxide in solid form reacts with water and forms calcium hydroxide and heat is evolved. So, although it seems that this is exothermic reaction, but we are not going to classify this on the basis of exothermic or endothermic. We have to identify the type of chemical reaction, that whether this is combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction or a redox reaction. So as you can see here that here calcium oxide is combining with water and forming a complex substance. So this reaction is a combination reaction. So we can write here that this is a combination reaction. Then again, next is carbon burns in the presence of oxygen and forms carbon dioxide. So this is one kind of combustion, but carbon is combining with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. So this is also combination, and under combination this is combustion reaction of carbon. Then we have the combustion reaction of hydrogen, that is formation of water. So when hydrogen gas reacts with oxygen gas, it forms water. So this is also a combination reaction. In the next reaction, we have ferrous sulfate in solid form. Heat is provided to it and it is converting into ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. So here a complex substance on heating is converting into simpler substances. So this is called decomposition reaction. Next is calcium carbonate on heating gives calcium oxide and calcium carbon dioxide, which are the simple substances. So this is also decomposition reaction. Next is lead nitrate on heating gives lead oxide, nitrous oxide and oxygen. So decomposition again. Then we have silver chloride. In the presence of sunlight, it converts into silver and fluorine gases evolved. So this is also one kind of decomposition reaction, in which energy is given in the form of sunlight. Here it was provided in the form of heat. So this was thermal decomposition. This is photolytic decomposition. So this is also decomposition reaction. Then next is we have iron reacting with copper sulfate converts into iron sulfate, or you can say ferrous sulfate, and copper is displaced. So here you can see that iron, which is more reactive than copper, here iron replaces the copper from the compound and forms ferrous sulfate and copper is displaced. So this is displacement reaction, which is based on the reactivity of the elements. Next is lead reacts with copper chloride and forms lead chloride and copper is displaced. So again we are having displacement reaction Then we have sodium sulfate reacts with barium chloride and forms barium sulfate and sodium chloride. So here you can see the exchange of elements has been done between the compounds, and that is why this is double displacement reaction. The next is copper reacts with oxygen and on heating it forms copper oxide. So here you can see that what is happening, oxygen is getting attached with copper. So oxygen addition is called oxidation. Copper oxide reacts with hydrogen on heating forms copper and hydrogen H2O, that is water. So here removal of oxygen is being done from copper. So copper oxide is getting reduced. So reduction is happening here, and here addition of oxygen is happening. So this is oxidation. So this is a redox reaction. Then we have MnO2, manganese dioxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, forms manganese chloride, water and chlorine gas. So here also you can see that MnO2, earlier oxygen was there, but in the product side we are not having oxygen with manganese. So here the removal of oxygen is done from manganese. So manganese is getting reduced, whereas hydrogen HCl is getting oxidized and forming H2O and Cl2. Equation number 14 is as same as the 10th. Then we have 15th, silver nitrate reacts with sodium chloride and forms silver chloride precipitate and sodium nitrate. So here also you can see that element exchange is there in between the two compounds, and then it is called double displacement reaction. Then no need to discuss the second question, but yes, third question, why do fireflies glow at night? This is also a chemical reaction which is being performed in the body of fireflies, because of which the visible light emits. So what is actually happening here? So this phenomena of producing or emitting light inside a living being, living organism, is called bioluminescence. So on the basis of bioluminescence, the fireflies, they glow at night, and what happens that there are in the body of the fireflies lower abdomen one chemical reaction is taking place. And what is that chemical reaction? Here chemical energy is being converted into light energy. Here in the lower abdomen of fireflies we have one enzyme called luciferase. When this enzyme reacts with the other enzyme called luciferin, in the presence of magnesium ion, ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, this you will study in higher classes, or you will study this in bio section also. But this is the actually energy storage house of the cell. Then we have oxygen. So in the presence of all these two chemicals, they react together, and this chemical energy is being converted into light. And because of this luminescence produced because of the chemical reactions involved, the fireflies, they glow at night. Then we have question number 4, identify a reducing agent in the following equations. So dear students, I just want to tell you, reducing agent will itself get oxidized because reducing agent will help other element or compound to get reduced. And what when reduction happens? Removal of oxygen or addition of hydrogen. So these can be two things that can be done to reduce an element or a compound. So here, first equation, we have NH3 plus 5O2 converting into 4NO plus 6H2O. So here, what is happening? That this ammonia is, because here ammonia is having hydrogen, this side, nitrogen is having hydrogen this side along with it, and here nitrogen is having oxygen. What is happening here with oxygen? Along with oxygen, here at this side, addition of hydrogen is there. So you can say that this is getting reduced. But who is helping? Who is providing that hydrogen? NH3. So this will be our reducing agent, because this is providing hydrogen so that it can be attached to oxygen and it can form water. Next is H2O plus F2 fluorine forms HF and HOF. So here F is getting attached with hydrogen. So here also this is getting reduced. But who is helping? H2O. So this will be the reducing agent. Then in next reaction, Fe2O3 plus 3CO. And this side, what is happening? That removal of oxygen is happening with Fe. And removal of oxygen is what? Reduction. That means this is getting reduced. Who is helping? This. So that is means this is our reducing agent. Then we have H2NO2. H2O is formed. So attachment of hydrogen is being done on oxygen. That means it is getting reduced. But who is helping? This hydrogen. So this is our reducing agent. Question number 5 is identify oxidizing agents. Here we have Pb3O4, that is kind of lead oxide. Then we have hydrochloric acid forming lead chloride, chlorine gas and water. So here we have to identify the oxidizing agent. That means who is helping in getting oxidized? That means who is providing oxygen or removing hydrogen on the reactant side. So here, what is happening? We were having Pb3O4. At product side, we have PbCl2. That means removal of oxygen is done from this. So this is being reduced, and the which is being reduced is itself an oxidizing agent because it is providing oxygen to other elements or compounds in the reaction. So this will be our oxidizing agent. Here MgO2 forming MgO. So Mg is getting oxygen with it. So Mg is getting oxidized, but who is helping? O2. So this will be our oxidizing agent. Then we have copper sulfate and zinc. So they are forming copper and zinc sulfate. So copper sulfate will be the oxidizing agent. Next, V2O5. Calcium ke saath react kar raha hai. So it will be forming vanadium and calcium oxide. So here the removal of oxygen is done. So this is getting reduced, but this is behaving as a oxidizing agent because this is providing oxygen, which is getting attached with calcium, and this is getting oxidized. So this is our oxidizing agent. Question number 6. Which of the following are combination reactions? First, 2-KClO3. On heating gives 2-KCl, potassium chloride and oxygen. Here, because combination reactions are when simpler substances, they combine together to form a complex substance, but here it is not happening because one is breaking down into simpler substances. This is example of decomposition. We want the example of combination. Next, MgO, magnesium oxide, reacting with water, forming magnesium hydroxide. So this is the example of combination reaction. Then we have aluminium reacting with oxygen, forming aluminium oxide. So here also, this is combination reaction. Then we have zinc reacting with ferrous sulfate, forming zinc sulfate, and iron is displaced. So this is example of displacement reaction. So second and third are the examples of combination reactions. Then next is, what are neutralization reactions? Give one example application. So dear students, neutralization reactions are those reactions when in which the acids and bases in equal amount, they react together and they form salt and water. One application of neutralization reaction is that these kind of reactions, they help in neutralizing the effect of excess acid or excess base. So generally, they are the substances which are formed here, they help, or the salts which are formed here like magnesium hydroxide or calcium hydroxide, so they help in treating and hyperacidity, or you can say the excess of acids in the stomach. So they are also called antacids. So this is one of the example of their application. Then next is, explain the following terms, corrosion and rancidity, their preventive methods. So there is no need to discuss this question, I guess. Write 5 methods to prevent corrosion. So they can be galvanization, electroplating, painting, or oiling. So these can be the methods to prevent corrosion. Then next is, write one example of each of the following. First, exothermic reaction. So exothermic reactions are those reactions in which heat is developed. So any reaction which is involving the production of heat or which is involving the raise in temperature of the container, that can be taken as the exothermic reactions. One exothermic reaction can be taken as the respiration reaction, which is one of the combustion reactions, but it is generating heat. So that is why respiration can be taken as one. Or we can also take the example of calcium oxide. When it reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide and heat is developed. So that can be taken as exothermic reactions. And the reactions in which we are providing heat, so that the reaction can be performed, called endothermic reactions, like calcium carbonate. On heating, it gives calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So these are two products formed, and this is the reaction which needs energy. So that is why this is called endothermic reaction. So this is all about the solutions of the assignment number 2 of chapter number 1. So dear students, goodbye and take care.